So there are plenty of these desk pad-like apps on the market, and Tweek is one of them. It's become very popular as a simple to-do list experience without any or too much fluff around it. Now, we're going to explore whether it's right for you, covering prices, pros and cons, and recommendations near the end of the video. So do check it out in the link in description if you're interested. Now, if you do want Tweek, you can find it below. You can also find toolfinder.co, which is our site for helping you to find the best software on the market. Feel free to find that linked below, and also a free guide to finding the best to-do list app if you're stuck and need some help. So let's start with the Tweek pricing. Now, I actually subscribe to the premium for this video, and the premium is fairly reasonable. It is $4 per month, which we're typically seeing with these sort of applications. Now, $4 a month gets you a few different things. The free plan gives you unlimited active calendars and the ability to share the calendar too. You get the iOS app and a few other print calendar abilities. But the premium gives you all of that, plus subtasks, recurring tasks, and also an integration with Google Calendar, which is their primary feature that makes them slightly different on the market. Now, the application at heart is pretty simple. You can see here, it's a simple design. It wants to be like a desk pad to help you to organize what you're focusing on for the week ahead. You can click into items and start adding some notes and subtasks below them, which is organized and structured in a nice way. There's also some basic formatting and a way to turn your items into recurring items as well, which means they'll repeat across your calendar. Now, there's also ability to set the color and also to extend them to additional days, as well as add a file, which might be a helpful addition. As you can see, I turned my color into blue and it highlights that on the page, which is quite nice. Now, these are items that have been pulled from Google Calendar. So as you can see here, they're pulled in from Google Calendar instantly, and that's a good integration to have as part of the premium. So one of the benefits that's also helpful is down here, you've got your ability to create a someday area, or maybe even an area for next week. And you can add items below them. So for example, if I add next week ABC, which is cool because I can drag items into the relevant list I'm working on. Now you can skip ahead if you did want to and see future dates as well. And every item that has a meeting link in it will be indicated with this little post-it note here, which is quite a cool addition. Now up here, you can also open your profile and switch between your calendars. You can share as many calendars you like and have as many calendars as you like as part of the free plan, which is good, and of course the premium plan. Now you can open your settings here and you can even choose whether you want to import a calendar and additional calendars as part of the premium. You can also sort completed tasks as well and rename your calendar from here. Now what's here down here is you can have additional items as well. For example, if you want to move your columns or add an additional column, you can do that. And it comes up as sort of like a grayed text, which is quite nice. And you can have as many of them as you like. Now, if I were to add an item here, you can start adding subtasks, which is quite helpful. Now you can star those subtasks, but that's all that you can do with them. You can't add additional days if that's something that bothers you. Now up here, you can also search your account to find something and do something called a printable account, which is great because you can then print it off and have it on your desk if you want to edit it visually. That's part of the free account as well. So what are the pros of Tweek? It's a very simple application, easy on the eyes and great for those who like that desk pad type experience. It comes with some good abilities with Google Calendar, which apps like To-Do won't offer. The cons are that this application is very basic. The abilities down at the bottom aren't particularly extensive and could be a lot better. And it's still priced at $4 per month. But for those who are really reliant on Google Calendar or want to add multiple Google Calendars, they'll really like this, as well as the ability to share calendar and collaborate with other people on it, which is quite helpful. Printability is also a great feature, but in general, this app is great for free users if they're looking for something simple and easy to use. So I recommend it for those type that want to see the calendar visually. So if you're still needing some help with to-do list apps, you can find a link below if you're interested. And of course, we're happy to help guide you through the best options on the market. So do jump over to toolfinder.co if you're interested. I look forward to helping you with more apps in the future. It's always a pleasure, and I'll see you very soon. Cheerio.